Well, it is that special time of the year where everyone starts as equals. Far back in the distance, memories of last season, positions and points tallies on the last day. That's all now irrelevant. It is all about the ultimate prize that lies a long way ahead. That buoyant feeling is here. New start, fresh hope. Get the season off to a flyer. The fans are believing. Here's a venue this which simply adds to the spectacle of the game it stages. One of the most impressive arenas in this part of the world. Everybody waiting to get the season underway. Everybody equal on the start line. Yes, Burnley have a free kick. To the left, we'll try cutting inside here, going through, great leap! Oh, just needed a better contact.
Well, plenty of moving targets to pick out in the box, obviously increases your chances of the ball being met like that by someone.
Gets wrestled off the ball. Sessegnon. There's a long ball. Promising move that. Good inroads into enemy territory, but no joy. Burnley get it back again. To four. Me. Kearney plays a clever pass. Shoots! Saved only by poor finishing. Fulham
are looking quite mean on the counter, and combating that requires even more meanness.
Tarkovsky, decent early chances, it bodes well for an exciting game. Taylor, played into space out wide, well positioned to make that interception. Eaton, and it's Brady. Wood, have just joined us, well, you've missed no goals. He scored! There is the breakthrough!
The understanding between those two plays a big part in that, and releasing the run on side proved the key ingredient.
A 1-0 lead established.
Well, just listen to the reaction. I think you can hear the approval from the support all around the stadium.
Sessegnon. He's played him through. He's looking to shoot. A great save, real class.
Well, what can I say? Truly wonderful goalkeeping.
whips it away. Battles to win it back.
Defending, albeit from an unexpected source.
You have to admire commitment like that, because he could easily ignore that and just kind of walk around and let others do all the chasing. But instead, he looks as if he relishes the chance to dig in for his team here.
He's got away. The shot's on! Back of the net! And already they're looking to run away with it.
Yeah, looking back at that, that's how you play on the counter. Quick and decisive and ruthless with the finish. I thought it was a stunning, stunning breakaway.
Burnley get themselves a two-goal cushion.
No doubt as to who has the momentum here now. The only doubt is how many is coming.
And it's got through. Mitrovic has a goal!
Oh, it's diehard defence and the willingness to put his body on the line. Very impressive.
Tries to get it forward quickly.
Wood.
Back. Fulham caught cold early here on day one, already 2-0 behind. Going through.
Wood.
Now it's to four. Acknowledges that he should have come up with something better there.
Oh, that just required a bit more oomph to reach its target.
Wood.
Cork. Stuck out of there for a good challenge. He's left his man. Mitrovic, header, it's a goal!
Well, you know, thinking about that, I think they've perfected that on the training ground, because it took them seconds to get the ball from back to front. They really commit forward in numbers too. It was all very well drilled.
Fulham get themselves back into contention.
Listen, goals change games, and that has changed the whole complexion of this one. They have the momentum now.
Cork. Hardsley. And it's Cork. Me. Taylor, Brady, he's making good use of his strength there, goes for it! Clear. Well, it really is one cross after another.
Well, with a target to hit,
the turtle soccer flick hits through the wall.
And efficient, because they all know what they're doing.
Tries to hey, Nick. Tits. How you doing, brother?
What's up?
What's up?
There's the end of the first half. Oh, a really good half of football. Three goals and just one separating them.
Well, it's still anyone's game, as both sides have shown they have goals in them. As for the next one, should it arrive?
How have you been, man? How's life treating Mr. Galambos?
Just back from your break, we've missed very little of the resumption of the second half.
Fulham need to get the balance right to sort this out. Ambition must be complemented by just the right amount of caution. I think the more experienced players can...
Going for goal! That really should have hit the net.
Good.
Change in personnel.
Good to hear. What are you doing? Playing Warframe?
Taylor, and it's Ward. Great.
Yas.
Ward.
Are you a pro at it now, dude?
It's a free kick.
Because if I decide to reinstall it at some point, you'll have to take me under your wing, teach me the ropes again.
Sessegnon, his goal scoring skills have already been evident. Fosu-Mensah lobs it in gently. How about a shot? And Mitrovic! And out to safety. Wood. Still they trail, and time is ticking away. Goodmanson going through. Lovely bit of skill there. In comes the cross. Flags up.
Look, I know our vantage point is very different, but he looked on.
Sessegnon was pulsing down that left-hand side. Played it short. Mitrovic delivers. Gets good distance on it. Referee's given a throw. Good throw at all, really. He's given away possession cheaply. Now it's Goodman's. And back to base. And now they can launch a counter. Out to the left it goes. Brady, he's got away. That's not the cross he had in mind. Good challenge, he just stood firm. And it's Mitrovic. Fulham, you need a pretty swift change of fortune here. Burnley have plenty in the middle.
They've planned to defend the aerial route and will do so with numbers.
Chip through and a shot. A terrific run to latch onto it, but the finish is all wrong.
It was such a clever idea to lift it into his path.
Burnley can make their change now with a break in play. And it's hoisted clear. Nieto. Hits one!
And that could come back to haunt them.
I can't hide away from how important that was.
Me.
Bardsley.
And it's Bardsley.
There's a real appetite from them to finally put this game to bed, but will they?
Shot a goal! It's in! Right back in it!
Get it!
Almost no time remaining! Game still on!
Fulham are really pouncing on any stray passes in midfield. We're talking seconds from interception to the back of the net. It's counter-attacking heaven.
This has become one superb game of football.
Well, the big question now is whether they can keep the energy levels up and try and grab a winner.
Cork.
Questions were asked. He's given the answers.
Concentration levels are very good, and so is the commitment. This game could yet yield a winner.
Sessegnon
with the smoothest one-on-one finish. He is one very cool customer.
Yeah, he always had the measure of the keeper, and there was very little doubt as to how this was going to end up.
Fulham chosen to bring on the last of their substitutes.
Well, for me, this was the obvious substitution. He'd become just a little jaded, and as a result of that, he was most likely to make a mistake. I think sometimes when the body becomes tired, the brain goes with it, and I think that's happened in this case.
Having turned the game on its head, now can they hold out?
There's still a bit left in it, Peter, but they should find the necessary to avoid a slip-up now.
Mitrovic
plays it out to the wing. Quite a run, and he's not done yet.
Time added on will be 2 minutes.
Fulham need to hold on for a few more moments. Good. And that is that. Day one, job done. The perfect start they craved. What do you take away from it all, Jim?
All those thoughts of Fulham. Won't we have been turned into an open day triumph? This level's looked bang on.
Just remains for me to thank Jim Beglin for joining us and to wish you a very good day.
welcome to what amounts to football heaven. It doesn't get a whole lot better than this. The conditions are utopian. The sky is blue and the players are with us for a football match so widely and keenly anticipated. Truly, this is pristine. And the level of expectation and excitement is reflected in the smiling faces of the crowd. They know it means so much, and they also experience between them a great sense of privilege at being able to attend this most special of games. One glance and you know where we are. It is one of the most recognizable arenas for the beautiful game in the world. And boy, does it add to the occasion. And already we're underway here. Jim, who do you reckon is pivotal?
Well, I think if we're hoping for something special, then it could come from Pedro. He may not offer much in the way of finesse, but he's very efficient, a good decision maker, a strong member of this lineup, so look out for him.
I think the opposition defence agree too. He's going to be the source of so many of their headaches. And he's there to cut it out. Chelsea in a good start to their campaign. A win on day one, up and running. Pedro.
Just to point out, Peter, that the fullbacks are quite high.
And what are they trying to achieve?
Well, it's obviously a move to push the opposition wide men back and give them more to think about.
Danger averted for now. That's a foul, no two ways about it. And back to base. Gets it upfield. And out to safety. Stare there tells the whole story.
Look, the game is full of ifs and buts. If only the pass could have completed its journey.
Sticks in a foot to win it back. Face to face with the keeper. Sessegnon, can he put it away? A reprieve, albeit perhaps momentary. Sessegnon. Looking to get within range. It's a pitch one. It's anyone's ball. Stuck out a leg for a good challenge. Hazard is fouled. Well, you might think he got off lightly. It is just a verbal warning.
Well, Peter, when you're up against a speedster, you've got to get to him early and not let him get into a stride. And they're just not doing that.
Christensen gets into the right position to intercept. And it's Hazard. That's been a question. And play for a throw. Great challenge. That's another throw. One in and he just whacks it away, and that has been clubbed away. Hazard, and it's Roberto Firmino.
They play the high line well, but it's always vulnerable to pace in behind.
Conte. And it's Moses.
through and he's had a quick look inside. And he heaves it forward. Chelsea get it back again. Shoots! Sessegnon. Aimed long and direct. He's on the back foot. Back into the middle.
Peter, we can only applaud that quality of tackle in the circumstances. It was probably goal-saving.
Hazard. Forward it goes. Not much subtlety, he's launched himself there.
And that's the end of that. It all started well enough.
Now it's Hazard. Gone a long way up and away.
And it's Firmino. Firmino kicks it out wide.
And he's onside.
Chance to cross here.
And the whistle goes for half time. So another team has broken through.
It's not for the want of trying.
An interesting game up to now. But still goalless. 45 minutes, it is still goalless. A change perhaps after half time. Already up and running for the second half.
Fulham can feel really happy with themselves. The scoreline doesn't back it up, but they've played with urgency and purpose. They can't afford to lose patience in this second half. They've got to persevere.
Chip through.
Jorginho
needs to run onto it.
Pity that, because they've had a decent chance of progressing.
Changes here, from both sides in fact.
Kearney. Sessegnon making use of the space out wide.
He's left his man. Can he score? He's delivered all right!
And that has only enhanced his already huge reputation. They're obviously hoping for an early second half boost, but there are a few who can truly make it happen. This is a very welcome tonic.
He was urged to shoot, and he duly delivered.
Yeah, it looks simple, Peter, but it requires intelligent use of space and a good understanding to pull it off.
Fulham themselves into the lead.
Half-time has been a blessing for this team. You know, what a great start to the second half.
Kante boots it to safety. Puts it back. Oh, tracking back like that, always appreciated by the crowd.
I think it's great to see that kind of application and desire from a forward who wants to help out his defence. I think, you know, any good team, really, your striker should be the first line of that defence, and he's delivering.
Sessegnon.
The chance! Going through, he's tried one!
We're actually not getting too tight, which is interesting. It's probably cautionary. Don't dive in, try to pinch it or intercept so nobody can get in behind.
Stitch defending, but that'll do. Looks to clip it forward. Boots it to safety. He's made sure that that won't get through. That's Schürrle. Nice little flick. Offside that time.
Just, it seems, but just is enough.
Final checks on the touchline.
A change about to occur.
Focused then on the defensive side of his game.
Well, they say that your front lads should be that first line of stopping the opposition, and I think he's taken it to another level with his desire to get back and help everyone out.
Who's chasing? And it's been taken straight back. Sessegnon plays it forward. He's got away. Has a swing at it! Lovely idea. Just didn't get it right.
There's no doubt he made the right decision, but without the right result.
Tackling here, and that one a perfect example. Moses, really good feet. Conte, is it in? And that could come back to haunt them.
I can't hide away from how important that was.
Both sides then taking this chance to turn to their benches. Intact, just.
Fulham are clearly looking to kill this game off. It's keeping the ball away from the other end too.
Sherlock spreads it towards the left.
There's a real appetite from them to finally put this game to bed, but will they?
Battles to win it back.
Peter, they have to fight the onset of desperation and keep enough cool heads to still deliver.
Hey buddy boy, guess who?
I think it's time for them to concentrate on closing this one out.
William. Who would call me buddy boy? I'm gonna go with Didi.
Well, it remains to be seen whether they can come up with that little bit of class to rescue the situation. It needs to be.
I think Didi said guess who last night. So I'm gonna go with Didi.
Wrong.
Okay then, I'm gonna go with Satan. Satan, you nearly always normally just say, hey Roman. So.
This game looked to have nil-nil written all over
and
it,
I don't think you ever say Gassu.
How you
doing, man?
Just remains for me to thank Jim Beglin for joining us.
Cheating bastard, emoji happy tears.
Oh, you know.
I'm good. How have you been?
Yeah, I've been good, thanks. A bit tired today, so I won't be staying on long tonight, but I thought I'd have a couple of hours before I retire to my pit. Team in a month.
Yeah, I feel again tired every day now, lol.
I know, man, it's all this access gaming, fucking Red Dead. Okay, I'm gonna skip this match and play Spain, I think. That's Spain, right? Yeah. Don't want to get injured in these internationals. little brickhead there, Harry Maguire. See, there's been another mass shooting over your neck of the woods today. Less than 2 weeks since fucking Pittsburgh, man. Depresses me, dude.
Well, a very warm welcome to you on this most pleasantly clear evening. As you can see, we are getting through the pre-match formalities and processes, the players coming onto the field for the usual fanfare and handshakes and so on. Conditions absolutely perfect. Temperatures are kind enough. It is an absolute picture under the floodlights here, and the match that follows ought to follow suit. So what a stage for the players to take to here ahead of such an important game. And we rise now for the English national anthem.
Not an ascent of victorious, happy and glorious, long to reign over us, Harry Brickhead Maguire.
Understanding is that it's going to be a 3-6-1 formation.
Well, I've seen it before, Peter, but it's extremely unusual. Whether it actually stays like we've been told, we'll gauge once the game is ongoing, but essentially it can be effective from both a defensive or offensive viewpoint. It all depends on the manager and his personnel and whether he prefers getting on the front foot or just thinking a little negatively. We'll have to wait and see.
As you can see, we've already started here. Jim, who do you pick out as the telling individual today?
It's hard to overlook Gerard Piqué. He should be given a bit more credit, I think, for his performances. Anticipates well, composed on the ball, and pretty good in the air. That'll all be needed for what's to come here, too.
Yeah, the scourge of so many strikers. Out to the left it goes. Sterling. Oh, that is lovely footwork. Has a hit! Wilshere gets it back. Wilshere crosses it once more. Rashford concedes a free kick for that. Beautiful, intricate passing. They are toying with their opponents.
Well, they know that their version of what...
Okay, there's the guilty party there. Maguire plays it forward. He's made certain that won't get through. Whistle's gone, that's a foul. Well, you might think he got off lightly. It is just a verbal warning. Oh, he's caught him there. It's a free kick.
Fucking hell, ref. Can we tackle? Are we allowed to tackle? Or?
Hoisted clear. Wilshere, if you have just joined us, well, you've missed no goals. Piqué. Sergio Ramos tries to get it forward quickly. Jordi Alba needed to come up with a better ball.
Yeah, the idea was right. the delivery wasn't. They can revisit that further on.
Back into the middle. Rashford, a chance!
Got kicked off for a minute there.
What, you're into that? You're into that drop.
Iniesta. Thiago. Now it's Lallana. Nicely measured pass. Can he score? Goal, England!
Get in, the lads.
Well, you've got to say, the odds on him missing...
Stop dabbing, Jesse.
And that's what the game is all about. Find space and finish, but we have to credit the pass to pick him out.
Got a new phone, but my YouTube keeps locking me out of my account for security reasons.
England break the deadlock.
That's strange.
Still a fragile lead, though. They can't afford to sit on this.
Iniesta. Hardly anything between the sides, and it's 1-0. It's Thiago. Jordan Henderson. Sterling. Oh, well intercepted, really alert to the danger. Koke. It's wrestled off the ball.
Fucking hell, Raf. Nothing wrong with that, mate. You shut up. You watch yourself, mate. Yeah, you watch yourself. Yeah, I'm watching you as well. Tell me. No, I did go through the back of him, I guess.
Flag.
Sergio Busquets. Thiago. More than happy to take the muscular approach. Thiago is alert to the possibilities.
Get him, Marcus. She gave up point for me. Good.
Marco Asensio.
Stamina's ruined.
Plenty waiting in the middle. He's in, surely. Sterling.
What happened to Nick?
Oh, he's playing Warframe.
England are leading with half time drawing close.
He's loving that at the moment.
As Piqueta knocks it away. And that's been lever clear. Who's ball? Who's going to get there? That's been a question. Sergio Ramos. That's been a question. Sterling with a good steal, well played. Cahill. And the whistle goes for half time. So there you have it, a close sport half of football. Had its moments, ultimately produced just one goal. Back on the first 45 minutes.
England clearly are benefiting from their homework. They've dealt with anything that's been thrown at them and have been smart on the break.
England head into the dressing room, pleased with the thought that they have that all-important lead. Analysis to come during the break. We are already promptly back underway. A solitary goal, that has been the crucial difference. It's a good run down the left-hand side.
Does Warframe have single player?
Yeah. You can play it on your own or with or with friends.
It's been taken straight back.
Or with strangers.
Sessegnon cutting down that right flank. Sergio Ramos positions himself well and cuts it out. Piqué.
But it's free to play anyway, so Nick can play that without PS Plus.
Marco Asensio. Iniesta. It's Diego Costa.
I'll have to check it out then.
Now it's Silva.
Yeah, it's pretty good, man. I enjoyed it. I played it a couple of years ago.
Fires it in low.
Really enjoyed it.
And he heaves it forward.
I think it's had a lot of updates this time as well.
Rashford. Sterling is effectively being mocked out of the game here. And they've got to be careful, Peter, that they don't allow their attempt to snuff out the threat now to turn into indiscipline. Wilshere battles to win it back. Jordan Henderson. Well waited. Rashford, he's got away. Piqué boots it to safety. Rashford. Cleared without complication. Ball is over the line. There's some activity down on the touchline. It seems there's going to be a change. Drilled in low. Isco brings the ball forward. Isco goes looking. Must needed to be better than that, and he knows it. Costa tried to play it through. Oh, that just required.
Was going to play Warface with Red, but he's never on at the same time as me.
Oh yeah, no, you're on Xbox. It's Warframe on Xbox. Rashford, I'm not sure. Might be a PS4 game. I don't know, mate.
Laid back in. Rashford. Big chance.
Go on, Rashes. Two assists for me. I think I'm going to get taken off now because I've got no stamina left. But set both goals up. Good day in the office.
Yeah, it's on here too.
Oh, okay. Yeah, it's pretty good, man. I made a little video of it a couple of years ago, a little like, montage video. It's good fun, it's pretty cool. Combat's nice.
The world building
was pretty nice, isn't it? Definitely one of the better free-to-play games.
Now the ball's come loose and the chase is on. He just whacks it away. And it's Iniesta. Ball's loose. Who's getting there? There are a few waiting for it. Towering header! Oh, should have put that away.
Well, they're definitely going about things the right way, Peter. A goal soon can bolster their energy levels now.
I'll check out your bit before I try it. I gotta run though. Good talking with you.
You too, Satan. Have a good night, mate.
And it's Jordi Alba. Iniesta. Jordi Alba. Time to deliver.
EOS. M.O.G. Turtle. M.O.G. Turtle. M.O.G. Cool smile.
Into the middle. It's not gonna find its target. Going for a throw. Fabregas. Iniesta. Crosses in a low one.
Thought you'd left, Nick. Stealth watching.
Lallana tries to stroke it through. Oh, he's broke. And the finish! Lallana hits one! They are rampant! And the lead is...
Fucking smashed them, boys!
And that is about as cool as they come.
Should have got my goal here.
Expertly.
Now that's what I call finishing, right in the corner. He knew instinctively who was where. He didn't need to waste any time weighing things up. That's a cracking goal.
England take a 3-goal lead and they are romping out of sight. Iniesta. Iniesta pulls off a...
Yay, insolent bubble attack at the right time.
Diego Costa. Busquets goes long. Wilshere plays it forward.
Ninja Turtle.
Dashing forward at pace.
Oh, there's the spider, I think.
Rashford pulls it out to the flank. And it's hoisted clear. And that is that. England, a class apart. Opponents torn apart. They are comprehensive winners. So what do you take away from it all, Jim?
When you get free-flowing football out wide with consistent supply into the box, it brings excitement and entertainment to the proceedings. That was a brilliant display of good wing play for me. And if that wasn't hard enough for the opposition, the link-up play was outstanding too.
Thank you very much, Jim.
And I've upgraded to black and red colour on my guy.
Sweet man. Send me another picture if you want. What weapon do you use, by the way? I didn't notice your weapon last time. Do you use the bow staff like me, or a sword?
Welcome to what amounts to football heaven. It doesn't get a whole lot better.
Sword, because to me it's badass.
The conditions are utopian. The sky is blue.
I only chose the staff because Donatello was my favourite turtle, isn't he? And he used the staff, so that's why I went for it.
The level of expectation and excitement is reflected in the smiling faces of the crowd. They know it means so much, and they also experience between them a great sense of privilege at being able to attend this most special of games. One glance and you heads it! I just couldn't turn it in.
Now that was a slick move, and there were several options in the box to pick out.
Oh, what a finish.
There it is! Well, no goalkeeper would keep that out. It really was a bullet.
And the contact was fantastic. Right on the bootlaces, and it packed a lot of venom. But it was a really potent strike.
Will it be me? Good night, screaming.
Hog. Had a Janai. There were better options before the ball was lost. Easy to save from up here, I know. That'll be a throw. Kearney. Fulham have enjoyed a fine start to the season. 6 points out of six. Osimensa. Looking to shoot. It's in. Two up. Too easy. How many more to come? And he was urged to shoot. And he duly delivered.
Yeah, and teamwork was key to that. A beautiful piece of engineering to set him free in the box.
Oh.
starting to look very comfortable.
No doubt as to who has the momentum here now. The only doubt is how many is coming.
Well, it did look promising to start with, but that looks a foul. Yep, referee's given it. Fulham, surprise winners in their last match. Need a mug of a few pundits.
He's got options out wide. And he's got good distance. Who's chasing? Seems now to be all about width.
Well, when you have the personnel to create in wide areas, then they need to see as much of the ball as possible.
Jurgensen positions himself well and cuts it out. Ramadan Sobhi.
Just brushed off the ball there.
Loose. Oh, it's opened up nicely for him. It's anyone's ball. Whistle's gone, that's a foul.
Fighter of the night,
you have to understand the frustration of the night here opportunity, but it had to be done.
Fulham with a chance here to increase their lead. This certainly looks appetizing, well within shoes. Kenny! Forward. Lerva hoists it high. Fosu-Mensah. Mitrovic looking to force his way through. That's a hit!
Pish!
That is wayward.
Sessegnon just had too many bodies around him. He would have done remarkably well to score from there.
Dragged it.
With a better ball.
Moy clearly is miffed having made the run and not get picked out.
Huddersfield have a free kick. Knocks it away. Gone for a throw-in. It's a loose ball. Could move up a gear here. Now it's Mitrovic. Big chance! Robbing chance! And it's there! And they are cruising away.
Very unselfish from Mitrovic. What a guy.
Fulham are really straight passes in midfield. We're talking seconds from interception to the back of the net. It's counter-attacking heaven.
Take a 3-goal lead and they are romping out of sight.
had a Janai.
Out wide to the right. Here it comes. And he's there to hoof it away.
Soon I'll look like the big leagues one day. I bet you already do, man. Keep at it, Nick. Grind that Warframe out.
Battles to win it back. Jurgensen plays it forward. Eater. Mitrovic. He's through the middle. Room for a shot. There are a few waiting for it. He'll have a kick! Oh, extraordinary.
Well, he did get himself into a good position. Something for him to cling to.
Fosu Mensah. Kenny, and it's Mitrovic, lobs it in gently, and that's been lever clear. Ramadan Sobhi dashing forward at pace. Chambers, reached half time. Well, there's plenty that can be said about the last 45 minutes, but one thing that cannot be said is that it's dull. One-sided, yes, but packed with excitement.
Peter, do I really need to say anything, or can I simply refer you to the scoreline?
Fulham very much in control here, three up and cruising. And we are already promptly back underway. No changes at the interval from either side. Hit long and direct. That's a throw.
Sensation. Never saw nothing in the vision.
Looking for space out wide.
But credit to
and it's twisted clear.
Won't make an exception.
Great leap! Went with his head but couldn't steer it in.
Sessegnon.
Good run down the left. What can they make of it?
Penalize him, penalize him, penalize him. Not your team, Roman.
How you doing, Connor? Alright, man.
Needs to get it forward quickly. Pushes it out wide. And it's got through. Oh, that is lovely footwork. Kachunga. And that has been clubbed away. Huddersfield can make their change now with a break and play. Diakabi. They're actually not getting too tight, which is interesting.
No. It's probably cautionary. Don't dive in, try to pinch it or intercept.
Give the bloody red card, you pissy fool.
You might get one now.
I have to say, I'm not convinced. Sorry, that looks like a dive to me.
A dive?
Fulham have themselves a chance from the spot.
Didn't look like a dive to me. Definite foul.
To further improve their position of comfort.
Pathetic.
A cool head was needed there, and we got anything but. Liver.
Finally a foul caught.
Great strength, too strong for his opponent.
Forward it goes.
Sessegnon really got caught in a trap there, and he just couldn't get out.
Caught in a trap, I can't get out, because I love you too much, baby.
Sessegnon did well to step in there. That was more than necessary. Loy. Adesanya. Fulham haven't made a substitution yet.
Come out, ye black and tans, and fight me like a man.
She just stood firm.
Is it?
Mitrovic. Sessegnon, scorer already in the game. Just wouldn't be beaten there. Defence got the better of him this time, but I'm sure he'll go again.
Show your wife how you won medals down in Flanders.
Show my wife how I won medals in Flanders. That's a reference, I don't get that. Oh! 4-0.
Performance. They are in complete charge. That's no fluke. It's what he was there for.
Well, as they say, Peter, if you don't speculate, you only speculate. We've just witnessed a player who was rewarded for his willingness.
I'll never have a wife anyway.
I
think marriage is a sham.
Boys. This is going. That's a foul.
Bitten by an insect or something. Elbow's itching like a bitch.
Boots it to safety. And it's Mitrovic. Williams. Adesanya. Hogg. Williams. Played out to the right.
Read the two previous comments from oldest to youngest and you will hear a song.
Oh, okay. Come out, you black and tans, and fight me like a man. Show your wife how you won medals down in Flanders. Oh, I don't know what that is, man. Never heard it.
Steered it beyond the post. Schürrle. Confirmation that there will be 2 minutes stoppage time.
It's an Irish rebel song.
And that's that. Fulham have won big and in style. Everything went for them. Their poor opponents left chasing shadows. A scintillating performance. If you sum up what we've
not familiar with it, mate.
Fulham gave themselves a dream start in this by scoring with their first attempt. You know, it served as a huge confidence.
Something in my E6 broke. It tastes like shit. What you do to me? Irish Rebels. Who are the Irish Rebels? They're a band.
Look it up, just search, come out ye black and tans.
I'll have a look, man.
welcome everyone to a part of the world where a game of
no, I mean Irish rebel as in when Ireland split from England.
A healthy tension, great expectation building up as we head towards kickoff. It's a bit grey overhead, and indeed the forecast
like a folk song.
A drop or two of rain as the day grows older. Notwithstanding that, there is a lovely backdrop here. The ambience is good. It's a smashing noise from both sets of supporters, and the game will be underway very shortly. Certainly, this is a very, very impressive venue. Quite a sight to behold. And already we're underway here.
Cleared without complication.
Tries to get it forward quickly. It's a brilliant interception. Federico Fernandez gets rid without sophistication. Newcastle have so far failed to win any of their three games this season. It is a trend that surely mustn't continue. Kearney. Mitrovic. Has a pop!
Oh, what a fucking goal! What a fucking goal.
Things to come. He could make himself unplayable here. On some occasions, when star players really mean business, the entertainment value rockets, and we could be in for a treat after such a stunning opening.
The keeper deserves some sympathy there. He may not have seen that until too late.
Keeper never saw it. Never saw it until it was too late.
Fulham ahead, one goal to the good. Christian Atsu. Fulham turned on the style in their last outing. The fans will want more of that. Kenny. Fulham have hit the front early, a foothold in the game.
Well, they've managed to get their noses in front early because they've been much quicker out of the stalls. They've set a high tempo and intensity. Look as though they want it much more at the moment.
Chambers. Kearney. Fulham are very much in charge here. Dominating possession and a goal to the good. Fulham scored early, of course, and it's 1-0. Away from immediate danger. Sessegnon has been in fine form lately.
Very fine form, I would say. James is definitely helping a personal run of success now, and he can do little wrong. He's full of energy and enthusiasm. It's all going great.
Choncho Shelvey.
I was selling relics and a guy was so savage that he gave my in return a lot of crime blueprints.
A great goal! Can he finish?
Oof. What's that? What was that message? I was selling relics and a guy was so savage that he gave me in return a lot of prime blueprints. I don't know what that means, Nick. Do you mean on Warframe or blueprints so you can build new stuff on your actual Warframe?
Yeah, mate. Relics defending, but that'll do.
I didn't play it long enough to get into the metagame of it, man. I don't know what Relics and Blueprints are. I do know what Blueprints are, I remember now. Because in your ship, you've got like a little terminal, right, where you can like upgrade all your stuff.
There. Chambers did well to emerge with the ball. That's a contest to keep an eye on.
Prime, as in Liberty Prime.
Nice touch.
Optimus Prime.
Kenny. And he's cut it out. Gets his foot in there. Muto has got himself a free kick. Just whacks it away.
Liberty versus Optimus.
Optimus would win, man.
Now it's Mitrovic. Tiami. Try as they might, they just couldn't get into an attacking area.
But infinite nukes.
Fernandez.
I think Optimus could just quickly transform and drive away in that really fast articulated truck. I'm not sure a nuke could affect Optimus. As long as he wasn't in the blast radius, he could withstand the radiation, that's for sure.
Boots it to safety. And it's hoisted clear. On the right now, what's on? Kenny, out wide to the right, back into the middle. Kusun-Yung. And it's Shelby. Muto. And it's half-time here.
Got it.
Off they go for half-time. This did indeed cover the first half. Only been that one goal. It is very, very tough. I'm sure they'll be very.
But Liberty took on 420 megaton nuclear missiles in Fallout 3.
Fulham,
you make good points.
Heading in for half time.
Well, I like Optimus more, so I'm still going for Optimus.
We're already back underway here. A solitary goal. That has been the crucial difference. Chip through.
Optimus is my boy from childhood, man. Although he wasn't my favourite Transformer. My favourite Transformer was Decepticon. In fact, my two favourite Transformers were both Decepticons.
Lascelles, Newcastle, on the receiving end of some fairly harsh criticism, mainly about the tactical choices made by the boss.
Listen, there's just no hiding place. And it was refreshing to hear him admit to getting it wrong. He miscalculated. Human error.
Iron Giant lost against Liberty Prime.
Kenny. That is terrific skill. Chooses to go back. To add to football's endless list of could-haves and should-haves.
Ah, quality deserted them when they really needed it.
Questions were asked, but he's given the answers.
This is the ultimate showdown, ultimate destiny.
Your impression so far, Jim?
Well, this lead is beginning to look a little delicate. I'd rather see them show the ambition and adventure to go further ahead. But it seems as if they settled for a riskier approach now to defend this.
It'll be a throw-in. There's going to be a change now with the ball out of play. It's going to be another throw.
Nicole, look up about Liberty Prime's endurance and raw power.
I'll just concede that Liberty Prime probably would beat Optimus Prime. But I'm still going for Optimus.
That's what has to be done now. No
question
about it.
I can't not go for my boy.
There's not too much subtlety or sophistication.
Even if I'm a losing team.
It really is a question.
I love an underdog.
Needs must. Well, there's no two ways about it. This is what they have to do. Forward it goes.
Oh, there's another one anyway. What about Rodimus Prime?
More than happy to take the muscular approach. Keeper goes long.
And Rodimus Prime in Transformers the movie, right? When
too tight, which is
Optimus dies and Hot Rod becomes Rodimus Prime.
Can't
think of any other Prime, so Amazon Prime.
Looking for space out wide. Kennedy. Over to the left.
Those nukes are meant to be used against sites.
Kennedy cuts a frustrated figure right now. He just cannot get away.
He needs a minder, and one of his teammates should be picking up on that, and quickly.
Richie. Hosolu. Diame. It's a good looking. Massive leap! Could come back to haunt them.
That had a lot resting on it, you know, Peter, and he's visibly cross with himself.
Yet it took four of them to reduce Liberty to parts.
Attention, and it should can't be even, from here, but they want to double their advantage.
Remember Liberty Prime dying, to be honest.
Forward it goes. Shakes the shot.
Oh, come on.
Really well taken.
Come on.
Goal. And there's the goal they've been looking for.
The only thing I remember about Liberty Prime is walking down that road with him. As he blew the shit out of everything.
Nobody sensed where the danger was lurking, and the finish was made a lot easier.
When one could destroy a city, it took four to put him out of commission.
Fulham had a couple of goals without reply. It's 2-0. Goodwin. Sessegnon, great challenge. Rapidly approaching the end, so it is looking now like 12 points from 12. Kennedy, and he heaves it forward.
Sessegnon,
it's good progress he's made on the ball. Where to next? Now it's Mitrovic. Beautifully done. Crunching tackle. In towards the centre, and he just whacks it away. Rondon, Hosolu. Referee looks at his watch and blows his whistle. Fulham did it. Terrific team effort to satisfy.
Could Optimus do that? No, survive 420 so. Megaton nuclear missiles.
I don't think so. If you can back that up with an early goal, it just he got fucked up getting shot by Megatron and falling off a bridge, so probably not.
So that's it for today. Thank you, Jim, and good afternoon all.
Optimus got major backup there, man. The Autobots never leave him behind.
Posse Liberty is superior.
Depends on what the situation was. If Liberty Prime just strode into town and Optimus was there with all the Autobots, I think they'd be able to do him in, and the Dinobots. Top of the league, what's going on?
Liberty would brush those shots off like it's nothing.
Yeah, I think you're probably right. I can see it already.
Good day to you on a grey day here, which promises rain, but promises way beyond that.
You only got to knock him over, though, and he can't get back up, Liberty Prime. So if Optimus Prime just drove into his ankle, might be able to knock him down. Then he could get his sword out and cut off his nuke launchers, so he hasn't even got a nuke to fire.
And are well covered up against the elements, whatever they may throw at us. Over the next hour or
pretty
two.
Slow Liberty was.
And this must be amongst the favourite arenas of supporters all over the world. It really does have a very special feel.
No agility.
We have already started here. Shoots! That really should have hit the net. Do I really need to tell you, Peter, that he has
to... You have to agree with YouTube that there. Liberty Prime has nukes.
Off the ball there. Good run, ultimately thwarted by an astute piece of defending. Crowd appreciates good football all round there. Aimed long and direct, and he's there to cut it out. He acknowledges that he should have come up with something better there.
Yeah, the problem is I don't know what Optimus Prime's made of, man. It's obviously not steel, because he comes from Cybertron, so it's a different kind of metal. Maybe he'd be immune to like a nuclear blast.
And that's been well dealt with. Milivojevic,
the bomb would have to actually hit him quickly to do explosive damage.
Crystal Palace have opted to really stretch the game now. Yeah, that's pretty evident, but what's their thinking? It looks as if the opposition are happy to defend the width of the 18-yard box, trying to remove that compactness. That will go straight through to the keeper. No change to the score. 0-0 it remains. Sessegnon is fouled.
Was that Transformers name that could eat planets, man? I can't remember.
Well, hey, at least Liberty Prime is still badass.
Oh yeah, there's no denying that.
Intercepted, really alert to the danger. MacArthur tried to play it through. MacArthur encouraged the pass with an intelligent run, but the pass just lacked pace.
Dinks one in. Goes for goal!
Oh, another beautiful finish.
First blood drawn.
Flying Ryan's on one, man.
Fulham are so well practiced in the art of keeping the ball through, wonderful passing and moving, and a real appetite to ensure it's reflected in their goal count.
This is also a chance to see what happens to their level of concentration from here.
He's got away.
Plus he survived multiple orbital nuclear missiles impacting on him, the four nukes I talked about.
Yeah, Liberty wins. He's the strongest prime.
And he
scored! It should have been a goal. That's a great flick on from Mitrovic.
But there's one thing, those prime have a laser like the Liberty know, so that can slice prime in half.
Going through.
Oh, well played. He's taken that really cleanly.
He's got his sword. I'd be pretty good at slicing shit up.
Mitrovic. He's tried one.
Sorry, I heard that comment wrong. I don't know if Liberty's got a laser. I just know that Prime's got his badass sword, Optimus. But I think you're right. Liberty would win.
Benteke.
The battle of the Primes.
Is it out of harm's way?
And it's Mitrovic.
Mitrovic. Can he finish? He's good for it!
Ah!
Great build-up.
On a plate.
He deserved a better ending.
I thought he did so well to exploit the space that was afforded to him then.
Ah, oh, should have been buried. That should have been buried.
Both 3 and 4 of Fallout Primes have lasers.
Off the ball. Who's ball? Who's going to get there?
Can't you remember Liberty Prime being in Fallout 4?
Benteke has a look to the possibilities.
When did he come into that?
It's fruitless.
Oh, I've got a really bad memory, but...
And it's Benteke. Mitrovic. Intervention. A slightly better ball would have led to a very different outcome there. Fulham seemed to have chosen a tougher route through the middle. That was easily read and dealt with.
And it's Mitrovic. Sessegnon already, of course, on the score sheet.
That is quite a run he's making here. A chance to play it in. Thank you. final action of the first half.
Hey everybody, just stopped by to say hello. Have to watch Supernatural, so I'll be back and forth, then back and forth, then back and forth. He.
I'm going off after this game. Who's that? Who was that? Oh, Dee Dee. Hey Dee Dee. Hey Dee Dee, I'm going off after this game, dude. So you go and enjoy your show in peace.
Hi Dee Dee.
No interruptions.
So we're just settling back into this second half. Fulham really need to go and grab another goal now, Peter, if they're going to go on and secure this. Late back in. Now it's Johansson. Kouyaté goes looking. Zaha breaks on here. Mitrovic.
Hi YouTube.
Chip through. And he just whacks it away. Yet another to add to football's endless list of could-haves and should-haves. That was just poor decision-making and a weak execution. Crystal Palace are keeping their men at
I'm the motherfucking D-O-double-G Snoop Dogg.
Deny Wunners the opportunity of going beyond that rear guard. It's Benteke. Meyer.
What's my motherfucking name?
Out to the left it goes. Out for a throw.
Lordy dawdy. We likes to party. We don't cause trouble.
Zaha.
We don't bother nobody.
Going through. Can't get the better of his opposite number. Zaha has got himself a free kick.
Well, he was the one player you had to keep away from the area. Not the best way to do it, though.
So tired.
Well, you might think he got off lightly. It is just a verbal warning.
Wilfred, come on, mate. Nothing in that.
Away from immediate danger.
How would you react if the real Snoop joined the stream?
I'll tell him I lost a lot of respect for him a long time ago when he sold out. Time to get the fuck out. Because he let me down. Him and Dre.
In for a throw in. There's going to be a change now with the ball.
Get the munchies.
So get the fuck out, man. Go call Ice-T and tell him come in here instead.
To win it back. Plenty of appeals, but the referee is not interested. Over to the left. Zaha floats one over. Gets it upfield. Oh, no, that's not the ball he wanted.
What about Barack Obama?
What would I say to Barack Obama?
It was physical, no nonsense, and it had to be. Hit long and direct.
Stitch
defending, but that'll do.
I'm not as invested in him. Never been as invested in Barack as I was in Snoop when I was younger. But I was well invested in Snoop. He was like my favourite artist for a long time. Doggy Style is one of my favourite albums of all time, man.
Spreads it towards the left.
But he's done nothing since. It's anywhere close to it. And then he just sold out. Started doing songs with Justin Timberlake and shit. Now he's just a fucking idiot. Still acts like he's 19.
Sessegnon.
Yeah.
Closing in on the last quarter of an hour.
I'm indifferent to Barack, so I'd just say hello, I guess. Hello, Mr. President.
I just think they're sending out the wrong message. This could backfire. He's got away.
I try and do my Barack Obama impression. It's not very good.
Good ball retention, and it should be enough.
Because I've not heard him talking enough.
After I burp and wipe my chin, I'd say don't tell Michelle, hee hee. What about Bill Cosby or Donald Trump?
It's tell them both to GTFO. I'll tell Didi or Nick to swing the ban hammer instantly.
Put this game to bed, but will they?
And I'd also ask Bill Cosby how he's getting internet in prison.
Oh, and that should have been two. Oh, and a real chance to pile on the pressure.
Before I kicked him out.
To get another.
Benteke. Frondelli. Zaha. Surely drilled in low. And he's there to hoof it away.
What about Kim Jong-un?
Well, I don't know any Korean, so...
Tell them they better not grab your pussy.
Wouldn't be much... There wouldn't be much point with Kim Jong-un, because I don't know
Roman
any Korean.
If Roman votes for President, vote for Heim.
I guess I'd say... Are you wrong, Ri? So wrong, Ri. So wrong, Ri. Team America once, and I know that was his dad, but you know, same thing applies.
Zaha, it's a loose ball. And time is up. Fulham, hold on.
Actually, if Donald Trump came in, I'd start. I'll just start praising Jim Acosta and CNN. That seems to piss him off. I've seen the clips today of him losing his cool with Jim Acosta. And he's taken Jim Acosta's press pass off him, so now he can't go to the White House briefings.
What about Charles Manson?
What would I say to Charles Manson? Not much, really. I wouldn't like to give him the satisfaction of speaking to me.
If he was alive. Yeah, he was pissed about the losses.
Yeah, it was funny, man. That fucking latest Trump interview was funny. You can just see what a baby is. Just an absolute baby. He can't handle any kind of fucking harsh questioning or criticism or... Oh my god, it's embarrassing, really. And he called that other reporter a racist because she asked him about.
What about Ringo Starr?
Ringo Starr? I'd ask him what he preferred, being the drummer in the Beatles or being the voice of Thomas the Tank Engine. Well, not the voice of Thomas, but he did the narration for Thomas the Tank Engine back in the 80s. Favorite gig, being the drummer in the Beatles.
About the Queen of France or whatever it's called.
The Queen of France? I don't think France has got a queen. I'd ask John Lennon. I'd have a lot to talk to John Lennon about. I wouldn't know what to say. I'd be quite starstruck with John Lennon. They have plenty of queens. I think if any of those people came in, the first thing I'd ask them is, what the fuck are you doing in here? What are you doing in here, guys? Why aren't you doing your jobs? Or why aren't you dead? You know? I don't believe in the afterlife, Connor, so I'd have to ask him for some kind of proof. Yeah, I'd say I'd presume that I was going crazy rather than I was being contacted from the afterlife. I think it's far more likely that I'd be going nuts than there being anything after death. Johnny Depp, I'd ask him where the fuck he went wrong, man. What went wrong with you, dude? You used to be awesome. You used to make amazing films. You were a fantastic actor. And then you sold out. It's the same with all these guys. That's what happened to them all. They all sell out. Sold out and became a fucking pirate. And lost all credibility. For dollars. Yeah. Jack Swallows. I hate those movies so much. One of the reasons I hate them so much is because Johnny Depp was such a great actor before he started doing that tripe. I'd say you were Edward Scissorhands, dude. You were goddamn Edward Scissorhands. Harrison Ford. I'd say, why did you make Indiana Jones 4? Why did you do it? Why did you piss on all of our childhoods? You arsewipe. Sam Elliott. I'm indifferent to him. I've got nothing to say to him. Wait. I might be mixing him up. Is Sam Elliott the Jurassic Park guy? Or is Sam Elliott the guy from Roadhouse? Roadhouse. Sam Elliott, the gruff voiced dude from Roadhouse. Or is he Roadhouse, yeah, okay. I'd ask him how he's managed to not age since Roadhouse, because he looks exactly the same now as he did then. That's what I'd ask him. I'd ask him how cool Patrick Swayze really was. Was he really as cool as he seemed in every movie he was ever in? Rest in peace, Swayze. What's that guy's name from JFK? How many shooters do you think there were? That's what I'd ask him. And how fit was Marilyn Monroe? Oh, Swayze was the nuts, man. Swayze was the nuts. PewDiePie. I'd ask him to stop making videos. I don't know who that guy is. I think someone's mentioned him before. I know he's probably a YouTuber, but I don't know who he is. I've never seen any of his stuff. So I'd have nothing to say to him. What is this, man? What is this theoretical? Jacksepticeye, I don't know who that is either. Wait, has he got green hair? think he might have green hair. If he has, I'd say, why is your hair green? Okay, there you go then. I'd say, why is your hair green? Oh wait, I know, isn't he Irish? Is he Irish? Vladimir Putin, I'd say, what do you really have on Donald Trump? And can I see the tapes of him being pissed on by prostitutes, please? Yeah, okay, so that's why his hair's green, because he's Irish, I guess. Yeah, I'd have nothing to say to him either. Don't really know what he does. Al Capone. Yeah, that'd be a good question, Nicholas. Why haven't you made your wall? Why have you broken your promise? Your bullshit promise? Al Capone, I'd have nothing to ask Al Capone, I don't think. I guess I could ask him what any secrets he had about the US government or anyone involved, maybe. I think he had some CIA informers chatting to him, not sure. Donald Trump couldn't make a wall out of Lego if you bought him a box set. Teddy Roosevelt, Jesus, I don't know. I don't know enough about American presidents to know when he was around. You'd have to give me some kind of historical period that happened when he was around. I don't know anyone really pre-Reagan, before I was alive or old enough to know about American presidents. Or JFK, obviously. Teddy Roosevelt. I'd say, how do you get such a cool name? That's what I'd ask him. Never known anybody else called Roosevelt. Nixon. I'd ask him why he sent hundreds of thousands of people to their deaths in Vietnam for the sake of, I guess, another term. Yeah, that's I'd ask him something about Nam, I don't know what. I'd probably just give him some shit about Nam. Why he thought it was acceptable to kill so many innocent people. No. I think David Frost did a good enough job about the Watergate tapes, and wasn't that pretty much some of it anyway? I'd grill him on Vietnam. Perry, Why did you and Russell Brand break up? What happened? What did Russell Brand see in you? That's what I'd ask you. What did Russell Brand ever see in you? How did you convince someone as cool as Russell to go out with someone as fiendish as you and to marry you? I'd ask him if he thinks he's better than Michael Jordan. And if he said yeah, I'd get Nicholas to ban him. But before I banned him, I'd also thank him and give him praise for these schools he's opening and for his charity work, because he seems like a cool guy. But I don't know enough about him really. I haven't watched basketball since the 90s. You'd have to, if LeBron James ever came in and said he was better than Michael Jordan, I'd get you to ban him. What about Captain Smith from the Titanic? You know what? He was from my hometown. He was, Captain Smith. Pretty sure. Not 100%, but I'm pretty sure he was from my hometown. I'd ask him why he didn't get some fucking glasses before he set sail. Because how do you miss an iceberg that big? But yeah, pretty sure he's from my hometown. I'll have to check that out. Oppenheimer. Oppenheimer. Okay, it rings a bell, but I'm not sure who that is. Enlighten me. Oppenheimer. Why does that seem really familiar? German, I presume. Oh, okay, yeah, okay. Is it the guy who made the bomb, or is it just the guy who split the, who found out you could split the atom? Sounds like something you would say between someone's legs. Trust Dee Dee. Giggity. Giggity. Made it. Oh, I'd ask you if there's anything that you could possibly imagine that you regret, that anybody could regret more than that. And then I'd ask him how he lived with the guilt. Giggity, giggity. How he managed to live with the guilt of such an astonishingly bad decision. There you go then. That question would be answered quite quickly. Obviously, I'd ask all these people far better questions than this. This is just off the top of my head straight away, man. I'm like answering in less than a couple of seconds. Yeah, I'm going to have to go too, Didi. This theoretical questioning celebrities, dead celebrities, is it's at least 15 minutes now, I think we've been going. I'll give you two more, Connor. And then I'm going. Robert Gates. I don't know who that is. Bob Gates. I know Bob Gale. No, I don't think I've even ever heard of Robert Gates. Bill Gates, okay. I'll ask him why he doesn't give all of his money away. Well, not all of it. Keep enough for himself, like, to live his opulent lifestyle. But why doesn't give all the rest away? Any billionaires, that I'd ask them all that first. Because I can't imagine being a billionaire. I wouldn't be able to sleep at night knowing that I could be literally saving lives with money that I'm never going to use. And Abe Lincoln, that's your last one, are you sure, Abe Lincoln? I'd ask him if he ever kept his sandwiches under his hat. Because that's what I'd do if I had a hat that big. I'd keep my sandwiches under it. Okay. That's it, man. I'd make a great interviewer. I think that's what we've all learned tonight. Okay, dudes. You guys have a good night. Nick, Didi, Connor. Take care of yourselves. Enjoy your evenings. Sure, I'll see you all soon. Stay cool. Go on, bugger off, you little sods. I don't like hanging up on you. You have to hang up on me. You hang up. Hang up. I'm gonna close it. I'm gonna close it. There we go. One's gone. Go on, you two. Off you go. Go and do something more exciting, more entertaining, more productive. Okay, I'm going.